sa 100% of your income, a maximum of 50% should go to your operational expenses. Yung OPEX mo, yun yung pambayad mo sa payroll, subscriptions. Kung nagre-rent ka ng office, yung rent. Yung bayad mo sa computer mo, baka minonthly mo, doon mo siya ilagay. The good thing about sa ating negosyo is that hindi tayo capital intensive. Yung negosyo natin is more about cash flow management. May perang pumapasok, may binabayaran kang expense. Next, meron ka ring emergency, which is 20% of your income. Emergency funds, guys, is at least 3 to 6 months to even 1 year worth of your expenses. At least meron kang perang backup if in case mahina yung takbo ng negosyo mo. Kasi sa negosyo, sometimes hindi naman siya palaging profit eh. Then, around meron ka ring ipatabi for taxes. In this case, around 15%. Very bloated to siya, very conservative to siya. Most of the time, ang nangyari is that maganda yung income natin, gastos natin, tapos all of a sudden, sinabihan ka, uy, may tax kang babayaran. Pak! 50,000 pesos. Saan mo kukunin yung pera? Patay. Then you also set aside funds for investments. Yung investment naman, it may be investing in growth funds. Ito yung mga real estate, stock market, ganun siya. Or for your business expansion. What if dati hindi mo kailangan ng camera, but ngayon you have a client tapos kailangan mo ng magandang camera para mas maganda yung kuha mo sa kanilang mga products in order for you to market them on social media. That is a business expansion. And lastly is personal development. That's the reason why you're here, because you're learning something. You want to know more how to build your business. If there's one thing that you should always invest in this world is investing in yourself. Now, to clarify, I'm not referring to buying expensive clothes, buying expensive things para sabihin na mayaman ka. What I'm referring to is development mo sa sarili mo. You know, soft skills, yung knowledge natin, yung technical skills natin, because that's what's giving us the revenue in the first place. And of course, meron tayong mga desire, mga luho natin. Magbigay ng gift sa client mo, yan, dan mo kukunin yung pera. Gusto mo ba mag-travel, mag-team building, or donations? Baka may mga calamities that you would also want to donate. So ideally, sa amin ha, this is what we do, each of these, meron kaming separate account for that. May account kami for OPEX, may account kami for emergency, may account kami for taxes, for investment, and for desires. So bakit namin sinegregate, or bakit ganun yung ginawa namin? It's because yung thinking ng ibang tao, I'm just going to put all the money in one bank. The problem with that is, let's say meron kang 500,000 yung nasa bank account mo ngayon ha. Tapos gusto mo bumili ng isang magandang computer at saka camera. That is for investment kasi business expansion yun. So you're going to spend 200,000 pesos. Ang naiwan na lang 300,000. Without proper budgeting, ang nangyari pala is kailangan mo pala ng 400,000 to pay off your operational expenses. So if you did not segregate, you would think that you have a lot of money. But if you segregate it correctly, kung sinaparate mo siya kaagad, then may budget allocation ka na. Kung nakita mo na yung investment account mo ay worth 100,000 pesos lang, ibig sabihin nun, if you want to invest in something, yung budget mo is only 100,000. No more, no less. You don't get the funds from your operational expenses to invest something. Kasi yung operational expenses, that's a constant thing. Ang pangit naman tingnan, sabihin natin na meron kang computer, meron kang bagong camera, tapos sabihin mo next month, uy team, yung sweldo natin madelay ha? Teka muna, kakabili mo lang ng computer, kakabili mo lang ng camera, tapos sabihin mo sa team mo na madelay yung sweldo. See? That's a lack of cash flow management. Gets?